Okay, how to keep your face fat pads healthy? That was the number one question you asked me from a video I made the other day. Never age. Would you like to never age or to look the same today as you will in 10 years from now? For many that walk into my practice, that's exactly their goal. You maybe even want to reverse some of the signs of aging that you're seeing now. Well, it is all possible. For me, the most rewarding thing is seeing pictures 10 years from now from my patients and they have not aged. But what one thing should you focus on if you were pushed? In other words, if you pushed me and said, hey, what one thing would you focus on to do that? Is it bone? Is it fat? Is it muscle? Or is it skin? You guys are all obsessed with one thing, and that's skin. Luckily for you, what you do for your skin does help your fat to a degree, only to a degree. But let's be focused today, much more focused on your fat. You see, fat has what? Stem cells, okay? Let me tell you a story. I was in Beverly Hills. I got invited to a very small conference. I go up one of these nice hotels in Beverly Hills, and I mean, I don't know if I could get there again. I can get to the hotel, but you had to go through some back alley elevator up to the top, and I'm walking into this Congress, and it was a tiny room. I said, it must be in the wrong place. There's only 20, 25 Beverly Hills plastic surgeons, you know, the guys that are charging $50,000 to $150,000 for a facelift. Here's what we were bantering about. My interest there was platelet-rich fiber, and we were talking about, can that take the place of some fat? The most meticulous surgeons in the room, and this was a 1 hour discussion, adding fat to the lower corner of the face, to the, we call melolabial fold, to the, you call it the downturn mouth, marionette lines, whatever you want to call it. And why we were talking about adding fat was light reflection.
You can see here on the left, that's a younger face. The yellow represents the fat. See how robust that is? There's a lot of yellow. Look at, as we age, there's a lot of gaps between that yellowness. And when you see that, that is demarcating areas. That is a depression in your face where that fat's gone. And some of that fat does in fact grow where you don't want it. So it creates extra hollows.
You see, as you age, some of the fat hypertrophies, some of the fat, so it grows, sorry. Some of it shrinks or atrophies. So you get growth and shrinking of fat pads. That's what creates age. But down here you have muscle. That muscle that gets stronger pulls the edge of the mouth down. Two things. Does the muscle really get stronger as you age, or are you losing the support of the muscle to do its work because the fat's going? So the muscle is just hanging there. There's no fat to support it. It's likely that. But why the face fat discussion? The meticulous guys were adding fat down here for added light reflection, because this is the number one dissatisfaction for a facelift at year 1 to 3 is, hey, it didn't lift this downturn as much as I wanted to. A lot of it isn't the fact that there's a hollow, but because the fat goes, the light reflects the muscle. The muscle's red, it leaves a shadow. So that's how important face fat is. Those that are adding face fat here with their facelifts were getting better results because people weren't coming back saying, oh, my mouth is still downturned, because it was reflecting nice, clear, bright light back. You know, if you put bright light on you, you look better. If you put shadowing light, you don't. So face fat, a quick story to show you how important it is, but that is the number one thing that I would focus on. And today I'm going to give you solutions to keep your fat healthy, because that is what I meant for my last video. Number one, let's start with healthy weight. To keep your fat pads healthy, a healthy weight is important. Nothing makes me more happy than when a patient comes in for a face slimming procedure and I say, you know what? Why don't you lose 10, 20, 30 pounds and come back to see me and I'll re-look at you. And they say, I was gonna do that anyway. I say, now is the time. That means when I treat them, I need less product, less intense levels for my devices, and it's gonna work better. Then they come back in, I see them again after a month, two, whatever it is. They say, okay, doc, I lost some weight. I look, I go, you don't need anything now. It looks great. And you all know what I'm talking about. You've seen it in your friends before. Well, by keeping a healthy weight, you're keeping your fat pads healthy. I know this because we do cadaver studies and I teach anatomy courses. Here's a picture from one we just did in Beverly Hills in, I guess it was March. Why I was involved, I wasn't supposed to be. My flight was delayed by 24 hours. They said, you know what? Let me come and help you. I went and we taught the course and it was awesome. I do about and teach about 2 to 3 of those a year. So I know that some of the fat hypertrophies, some of it shrinks. And in the face, when you're at your healthy weight, that growing of the fat pads where you don't want it, the malar pad, the nasal labial fold, the edge of the mouth, it just doesn't occur. Because when it occurs, sometimes it doesn't shrink down the way you want it to be for a great aesthetic look, and you're stuck with it the rest of your life. So a healthy weight is number one. Number two, hormone balance. Now, I probably just sent shivers down your spine because this is a big one. I know a lot of you are frustrated with it. Let's start with estrogen. Estrogen does so many things. It helps increase blood flow to your face. When you get a lack of estrogen or become menopausal, or for one of many different reasons you get imbalance, your fat pad redistributes. How will you know this dramatically? I'll give you an example. When people hit perimenopause and menopause, they change the way their fat sits in their body. You get more truncal weight, weight down here, around the midsection, and you lose that shapely buttock area where the fat sat where you want it to be. So you get fat redistribution. So just by looking at someone, people go, oh yeah, they're 50 years old, 60, 70. What do they see when they assess that? The bending of the spine, kyphoscoliosis, and the fat pad redistribution from the hips to the midsection and away from the buttocks. Because the shape of a female says a lot about fertility and hormones. So hormone balance, that's an example of how you know it. Here is a list of symptoms that might indicate that you're out of hormone balance. So symptoms of hormonal balance, of course, irregular period, vaginal dryness, hot flashes really bother a lot of people, sore or tender breasts. Males will get this as well with gynecomastia. I said that the fat cells produce estrogen. That's why men get gynecomastia or breast and breast tissue. Chills, night sweats. That's why people don't sleep. Here it is, sleep problems. When you don't sleep, that in and of itself throws your hormone levels off. And I have videos, of course, on melatonin, which I'm a proponent of. Headaches, key. Memory problems, that's a big one. More and more research being done on that one. But I think you wanna be attuned to that in hormone balance. Thinning hair and dry skin, of course. The dry skin is going to lead to fat pad changes in and of itself. Talk about moisturizers in a moment. Mood changes, I'm not gonna talk about that one. Weight gain and slowed metabolism, a huge one. And weight gain, yes. More importantly, look for weight redistribution, the redistribution of weight. Now, I made a whole video on hormone replacement, bioidentical hormones. It's well worth watching. Things have changed. Suzanne Summers speaks about this quite a bit. I usually see her every year at one of the congresses called the A4M. And there's blood work and there's a physician locators. She's truly giving back to women to create awareness and solutions to this problem. Remember, adipose tissue, fat cells, can produce estrogen. So when excess body fat accumulates, it can lead to an increase in estrogen production, and that just simply can disrupt the whole hormone cycle, estrogen, progesterone, testosterone being the top three. Many people don't want, don't need, or aren't at the stage for bioidentical hormone replacement. I'm seeing changes in women, certainly in their early 30s. Many women aren't ready for hormone replacement therapy or bioidentical hormones, and you're on supplements. I know many of you are. Here are the top supplements you want to consider whether you're taking bioidentical hormone replacement or not. So here's an example, Women's Vitality Blend. Many of you are on these already. Check this out. Horny goat weed, you probably, many of you know that one. Maca root powder, I know many of you take that in some form of a tea as well, comment below. Tongkat ali, very important one. And for men, they can increase their testosterone by a couple hundred points. Now you may say, why do women want that and hair growth and so on? We don't see that, but women have a higher relative level of testosterone than men. Many people don't know that, but testosterone is important in women's balance too. As you know, many are on the pellets. I have videos on that and a complete one on Tonkat Ali. You can watch saw palmetto as well, cayenne fruit powder. Those are different ones, and you can comment below the ones that you are taking and work for you. Ashwagandha is another one, comment below. I can do a complete video on that if you would like. Number three, avoid excess sun. Why do you think LA, Texas, Florida, they're the top hot spots for aesthetics? One reason is the sun. The sun makes a ton of money for the aesthetic industry. Think their convertible cars driving down Rodeo Drive, outdoor volleyball games. Heck, you get sun while just driving your car. The rays coming in the windows of the car, I see it all the time. Photo damage. Well, there's something called MMPs, matrix metalloproteins. We study them with biostimulators a lot. Also, melanin. These are damaged by the sun. And your MMPs, by the way, that chews up your good collagen and elastin that you're trying to keep. You see, the sun emits UV radiation, particularly UVA and UVB rays, which can penetrate the skin and cause damage at the cellular level. UV radiation breaks down the collagen and elastin, but if you need a better demonstration, conceptualize this. Something you can see with your eyes, think about those prolonged sun exposure creating the blood vessels that are fragile on your face. The little spider vessels, the red blemishes, you may see them. These visible red and purple lines are difficult to treat and often we use lasers for them. Well, guess what the blood supply was doing? It was supplying your fat pads with nutrition and health. So if you don't buy anything else in the sun story, you can see those visible changes to understand your fat isn't going to be healthy after being exposed to the sun. Incidentally, window tinting, when was the first real window tint invented? 1966, mainly for heat coming into those cars. But really, for aesthetics and our purposes, the sun and the UV rays are more important. Number four, a great moisturizer, one with a high organic content of oils. Think sunflower, neem seed oil, jojoba oil, grapeseed oil. You can get these inexpensively from cold pressed oils that you can use on your face. My Ultra Moisture has these in, but when you have a nice moisturizer that's protecting that protective barrier on your skin, you're going to in turn protect your facial fat pads, proven and studied. Number five, avoid smoking. And if you don't smoke, well, you actually probably are. What am I talking about? Secondhand smoke. Pollution in your car. When you're sitting in your car in traffic and you have the vent on, what's coming in? Pollution. You're breathing that in. Proven, and it's very troubling also for cancer causing reasons. If you're in Vegas and you're at a casino, you know you're breathing in smoke even though you're not smoking. Marijuana, same thing. If you're around that, you're breathing it in. Smoking has been shown to increase also those MMPs, matrix metalloproteins, I told you, that's chewing up your collagen and elastin. The toxins and the chemicals present in the tobacco smoke can induce that oxidative stress and inflammation. You never want chronic inflammation. That's aging. And your collagen, elastin, and your natural hyaluronic acids will degrade. Number five, a healthy diet. I have a lot of videos on foods and broths and elixirs that can help boost your collagen. Think zinc, silica, vitamin C. If you're not a vegan, you want to think about proteins and collagen supplementation. That absolutely helps, and we see that in the glow and in the facial region. If you still want all natural and you're open to injections, think, I talked about stem cells being present in fat. Fat has about 10% stem cells. Your blood has 1% stem cells. Your bone marrow is your third source of stem cells, naturally within you. Of course, you see people using fetal stem cells from the placental origin and use other animal stem cells. People are doing all kinds of crazy stuff. But you have 1% stem cells here. we can harness it from a simple blood draw, spinning your blood down. So you know I talk about PRF, plasmafill.com. You can see 3D imaging. But essentially what we're doing, spinning your blood down, getting your own stem cells and then concentrating them, putting them back in. But guess what else is in there? Exosomes. And you know, you hear a lot of people putting in exogenous exosomes. Exosomes I hear from plants, exosomes from other people that are cultured, but you have your own exosomes we can harness. And those all provide growth factors, healing factors to help rejuvenate. What are we seeing? We're demonstrating this now scientifically. Your own body's fat pads, skin dermal thickness, and glow. So you can watch my whole video when I'm getting it done. It's about an hour long. I'll put a link in the description below. But we did a live session. I answered questions coming in. If you watch that 1 hour, you'll know just about everything you need to know about platelet-rich fiber. And you're gonna say, what about PRP? PRP is old school. There's additives, there's blood thinners. It's not nearly as robust as platelet-rich fiber, which is actually all natural. So PRF forms a fibrin clot. It's longer lasting, more pure, and PRP is an old school treatment at this point. Bonus tip here, exercise. Been proven to help your fat pads, also your bone. A caveat here, a huge caveat, weight training and lifting weights and your muscles and your body seeing resistance is very important, especially females, for bone and hormone balance. However, there's a problem here. What you don't want to do is high output cardiovascular exercise, such as you see it in triathletes, runners, long distance runners, sprinters. You see it in cyclists. They're out in the elements. They're exposed to cold, to sun, changes in temperature fluctuations, but more so, they're wasting away. Their fat pads are shrinking, but also because nutritionally, they're losing bone. You see them, they're gaunt, they're older. If you go over, I was in Hawaii and one of the triathletes was on, you go through the airport, you see those people. They look 10 years older than their stated age. They're a dream for a set of providers because you can make a lot of money from that type of face. It has all the elements you don't want. Fat pad changes, skin, vessels, fragility of veins. And so they look somewhat gaunt. So you want to be very careful of what form of exercise you choose, and I have complete videos on exercise for skin. Now you're gonna wanna watch this video on nature's gift to help lift your face and tighten your skin. Stay tuned here, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.